So we think we're in a great position here, and listen, this could transform the company, transform the region of Namibia and our partners as well. So we're really excited to drill this well.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Brian Reinsborough. He is the CEO of ReconAfrica, or Reconnaissance Energy Africa. And Brian, it's great to see you again. How are you?
Doing fine, thank you. Thanks for having me back on your show.
Yeah, good to have you along, and excited to talk about the news you had out recently. You sort of gave a bit of a corporate update, and we had talked about what was going to happen about spudding this new well, and that's now happened. So let's sort of take everyone back a little bit and take us to forward to today.
Oh, absolutely. Thank you. Yeah, it's a very exciting time for us and our partners in Namibia. You know, we made a decision to move our rig schedule to Kavango, and that happened back in January. And really, as a result of the geology what we saw on the Kavango well, or the Naingopo well, sorry, we had some really encouraging results, some oil in the system. And the geology really dictated that we needed to pivot and move to the Kavango West well. Now, onshore, you just can't pivot and drill the next day. You have a lot of stakeholder engagement to occur in country. And we have a really impressive team on the ground that works with all levels of stakeholders in country. Then we have to build a road and build a construction site, and that takes time. So finally, we got it to the market that we would spud by the end of July. We did. And it's an exciting time. A lot of eyes are on this well because of the potential we're testing. Not only in the Kavango well, but also the Great and Emerge Fold Belt. So we're super pleased in the location. The drilling team's prepped up, and the rig is running really well. So we're excited to see the results here in a few months.
Yeah, Brian, give us an idea about how big this well is going to be. I know you're going down about 3,800 meters or so. So maybe sort of talk us through the next couple of months and what you're looking for while you do this.
No, absolutely. The Kavango well is a really, really attractive prospect to drill. It's a very large structure, almost 20 kilometers long, 5 kilometers wide. Very well imaged on our seismic data, which helps us a lot. Our external auditors assess the resource potential of Kavango to be around 340 million barrels equivalent, unrisked on about 30 million barrels on a risk basis. So that's a large prize. We think there's upside to that number. And this is these are almost deep water type of prospects we're chasing onshore. And of course, onshore, we have the edge of a lower cost structure and accelerated time to first production. So all the stars are aligned on this one, and we're super excited to get this down to deep.
Yeah, and so, Brian, what's the timeline of all of this?
Yeah, so we spud the well on July 31st, and it's a 105-day well. So that puts us in the latter part of November to reach total depth in this well. And then it'll take some time to analyze the data. We expect to have results out to our shareholders into the market by the end of the year, hopefully. So things will go quickly. The group is drilling right now. We're on schedule, and we're excited to get this thing down.
Yeah, and Brian, just so people understand this particular area, I mean, you're this is very prospective, and there's some positivities around where you are as well.
There certainly are. There's lots of gas seeps in the region that we've looked at and analyzed. Our company drilled a number of wells in this region 3 or 4 years ago in different places. Certainly saw a lot of oil in the system. So we like what we see here. We have some modern seismic here, which really helps identify the structure. Four-way dip closures are geologically type of prospects that have a higher chance of success globally. So we think we're in a great position here. And listen, this could transform the company, transform the region of Namibia, and our partners as well. So we're really excited to drill this well.
And Brian, just to update, you were planning on doing some 3D seismic work, and you're going to move that to 26 because you've got so much focus going on the drilling right now. So just talk about that, because there is some stuff around the drilling that's happening as well, and things that you're doing.
Absolutely. Yeah, it's a good point. Thanks for bringing it up. Our 3D survey has been moved to 2026, largely because of the drilling right now. If we have success on Kavango, we're going to obviously evaluate it very thoroughly and then move our rig over to the east side of the structure and drill an appraisal well and hopefully test it. So that sequence of events really going to keep us very busy. So we have control over the rift and the 3D surveys been planned. And keep in mind, this will be Namibia's first onshore 3D survey. Breaking a lot of ground there as well. We like the rift a lot. We just have our hands full with the scale of what we have in the Kavango well and the Damara Fold Belt.
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense for sure. Brian, thanks so much. Good update from you, and we look forward to talking over the next few months as everything progresses.
Thank you so much. Exciting times here at Recon.
Yeah, exactly. Right. There's Brian Reinsborough. He's the CEO of Recon Africa.